Even one of the highest paid actresses of the country today, Kangana Ranaut, will tell you how difficult it was to choose a career in film because her parents were so against it. So can you imagine how it would have been for women to enter the film industry a century ago? The profession was so tainted that pioneering Indian filmmaker Dada Saheb Phalke was not able to find an actress to cast in his first movie, Raja Harishchandra, in 1913. He even looked for talent in Mumbai's red light area, but nobody wanted to work as a heroine in films. So the first portrayal of a woman in films was done by a man. The success of Raja Harishchandra made things a little easier for Phalke, so he managed to cast a mother-daughter duo played by Durgabai Kamat and Kamalabai Gokhale in his next film, Mohini Bhasmasur, in 1913. But these women unfortunately faced such a backlash from the outraged Maharashtrian Brahmin community that they were ostracized. This paved the way for the first ladies of Indian cinema. These were Anglo-Indian, Eurasian and Jewish girls who were open-minded and exposed to having worked in offices. These girls dominated the silent era of Indian cinema between 1920 and 1940. Some of the popular stars of the era were Ruby Myers, better known by her stage name Sulochana. She was working as a telephone operator when approached by Mohan Bhavnani of Kohinoor Film Company. Her early films included Telephone Ni Taruni and Typist Girl in 1926. She became a superstar under the Imperial Film Company, and it is said that she earned more than the governor of Bombay at that time. Another popular actress was Esther Victoria Abraham, or Pramila. She worked as a teacher in a Jewish school in Calcutta before being noticed by director Rama Shankar Chaudhary. She often designed her own costumes and jewelry. Interestingly, Pramila also won the first Miss India pageant in 1947. Mary Ann Evans of Fearless Nadia is most remembered as a masked, cloaked adventurer in Hunterwali in 1935. A theatre and circus artist, she was introduced to the movies by Jamshed Wadia. Nadia had an edge over her peers. She swung from chandeliers, jumped off cliffs, fought atop speeding trains, and even befriended lions. But the coming of sound in films in 1931 brought the curtain down on the cinematic career of these women. Their accents were just wrong, as the talkies had no place for their anglicized Hindi. The big shift started with Alam Ara, India's first talkie, when Sulochana, the reigning superstar, was replaced by a young actress named Zubeda. The new lot was not only comfortable being on screen and speaking Hindi, many also sang, and this synced with films also doubling as musicals. Devika Rani, Durga Khote and Shanta Apte were the stars of the new talkies era. After India's independence, some of the silent era actresses migrated to Israel, Canada and Australia with their families, while others tried their hands as producers. Most just faded away.